Here I have the still packed K1, the small brother of the K1 Max. I don't want to bore you with a lengthy unboxing, so let's unpack the thing as quickly as possible and take a look at it. There are also tips to help you get started and get even better results. Let's do it! Oh, what a blast! Oh. I think I need to settle my clothes and I'll be back short. In the meantime, thanks to my sponsor, which is PCBWay.
PCBWay offers high quality PCBs starting as low as $5 for 5 PCBs. Using KiCad with the PCBWay plugin, it is the easiest to get an instant quote. One click prepares and uploads the Gerber files to PCBWay, where you then can adjust and change the available options to your needs, add a stencil, choose their assembly service, and more. Then complete the order to get your professional PCBs within a few business days. Besides that, PCBWay also offers high quality CNC machining, 3D printing services, sheet metal fabrication and more, which makes PCBWay your one-stop shop no matter if you're a hobbyist or an established company. The Creality K1 is a smaller brother of the K1 Max, which makes it a perfect choice for small spaces. Besides the K1 itself, you get a box with supplies and tools. So, here I am again, and after unboxing, which was really quick, and removing the foam from the inside of the printer, you find a box, and the box contains 4 rubber feet, a nice touchscreen display, then a spool holder, a bag with Allen keys and tools to exchange the nozzle and some replacement parts for securing the tubes, and a screwdriver, also a wrench, then a scraper and a needle to unblock your nozzle if necessary, a flat cutter, a glue stick, and some grease for maintenance. Also a rubber-like band, of which I have not found out for which it is good, but maybe someone knows and can tell me in the comments. Then a USB stick containing the software as well as warranty cards, a user manual with comprehensive instructions to set up your printer and get it up and running. The top cover should be used when you print temperature-sensitive filaments like ABS. You also get a spool of Creality's Hyperpeel A to do your first test prints. The Creality K1 shares many of the K1 Max's features, as there is a maximum print speed of 600 mm per second and an acceleration of mind-blowing 20,000 mm per square second. The regular print speed is 300 mm per second. To maintain good print quality at these speeds, it has auto-leveling as well as input shaping. Both have a dual-geared direct drive extruder capable of extruding up to 32 cubic millimeters per second. Creality's Hyperpeel A is optimized for such high flow rates. For other materials, you may need to reduce the print speed, but during my tests I had no problems whatsoever running all the filaments I tested at 300 mm per second. The flexible magnetic PEI build plate is easy to remove and the 2 notches at the back make it easy to put it perfectly back in place. It provides good adhesion for almost any material and I had no problems during my tests and didn't need to use a glue stick. The key differences are the smaller build volume of 220x220x250 mm compared to the large volume of the K1 Max, which is 300x300x300. I seldom need such a big print volume, therefore the K1 is a perfect size to go. It's also much cheaper. I got mine in a Black Friday sale for about $400, which seems to be a good deal compared to the $700 for a P1P. The K1 does also not have the AI LiDAR and the AI camera of the Max. Both should be available to buy separately, but currently you can only buy the camera, which costs about $30. I hope the AI LiDAR will be available soon. It enables the printer to do a first layer check and to automatically adjust the flow rate, which is called motion advance. The K1 can be operated standalone, loading models from a USB stick, but can be connected to your Wi-Fi network for remote operation too. Getting the K1 up for its first print took me less than 30 minutes, including the self-test, which takes about 11 minutes. To set up the printer, do the following steps. First, mount the handle to the door. The next two steps are crucial to prevent damage. Remove the three transport security screws marked with the yellow arrows. Keep them. You need them for one of my must-do tips later on, as well in case you have to transport the printer. Next, check the switch on the left side matches your country's voltage. Put the four rubber feet on each corner of the K1. Take the touch screen and connect it to the flat cable, then slide it into the slots and push it gently down. Finally, mount the spool holder on the back, then plug in the power cord and turn it on. The K1 will welcome you with a first run wizard, during which you select the display language, Wi-Fi setup and self-calibration to tune input shaping and level the bed. Don't worry about the vibrations and sound, this is normal. It may also ask to update the firmware to a newer version. Do it because it will enable the option to get root access to unlock the full potential of the K1, get SSH access, install Creality's Clipper version, use mainsail or fluid, and more. I will cover this in detail in an upcoming video. There are some pre-sliced models on the USB stick to show the capabilities of the printer. A Banshee that prints in about 15 minutes, a lovely articulated cat to show the precision, and a test running at mad 600 mm per second, which is awesome to watch. Then I went over testing how well it works using PTG and TPU.
Printing ABS was okay, at least the part did not come loose during print. But as you can see here, despite the enclosure, has some warping. Probably the chamber temperature was not high enough, passively heated by the hotbed only. I think leaving on the hotbed at 90 degrees to 100 degrees Celsius for a while before starting to print to heat up the chamber will reduce that problem.
To prepare your models for printing, Creality offers a standalone slicer as well as a cloud-based web solution and an app for your smartphone. The latter reminds me a little bit of the AliExpress app with all the pop-ups, gamification and ads to make you buy a premium membership. As a K1 owner, you are eligible for a free 1-year premium membership, which you have to redeem until 31st January 2024. Then there's Creality Print. It's a standalone slicer to be installed on your PC. I used it for most of my 3D prints. It isn't as feature-rich as Ultimaker Cura or Prusa Slicer, but it's sufficient for most tasks. Sliced models can be either saved on a USB stick or, more convenient, directly sent to the K1 after setting it up. You then can monitor the print inside the slicer. As a third option for remotely using the K1, you can open its web UI in a browser. It also allows uploading pre-sliced SDL files and starting and monitoring printing progress. When scrolling down in the web UI, I saw the bed mesh my K1 produced during self-test. I was shocked to see that it diverged more than 1 mm in height from the lowest to the highest point. If your mesh looks like mine, or even worse, then follow me on adjusting the K1 to get a nice leveled print bed. Start with homing the K1, then move the bed all down to the lowest point until it doesn't move further. Turn off the printer. Flip the K1 over to the side and open the bottom panel. Loosen the two screws on the belt tensioner. Use a long screwdriver to push the tensioner to the right so that you can remove the belt from the left pulley. Turn the printer upright and put back in the three screws where the yellow arrows are and fasten them, but don't over tighten them. Now flip it to the side again, put the belt back on the pulley and screw the tensioner screws back in. Remount the bottom panel, put the printer upright and remove the three screws holding the bed down. Before turning the K1 on, delete the mesh data in the web interface. Turn on the K1 and start the auto-leveling from the self-check menu. Wait for it to finish, then reload the web UI to get the updated mesh data. This looks much better now. Finally, let's activate root access, which you will need to replace the stock K1 UI, which is very restricted, with the Clipper Fluid or Mainsail UI, to unlock the full power of a Clipper-based printer in the future. To do so, select the root account information menu on the touchscreen. You will see a warning informing you about the consequences when rooting your printer. If you are brave, tick the checkbox. The OK button will get activated after 30 seconds giving you time to make sure you really want to click it. After clicking OK, a dialog shows the account username and the account password. These are the credentials you need to SSH into the Creality K1, so write them down somewhere and put it in a safe place for future use.
Before I come to the summary, I would like to point out my upcoming Patreon, for which you can already sign up for the waiting list, where I will share some behind-the-scenes content, a member-only community, and more. Nevertheless, if you don't want to, I'd be more than happy if you subscribe to join the growing 3D printing geek community and leave me a like. I'm very impressed by the speed and quality the K1 offers for the price. Creality stripped down some of the exclusive features of the K1 Max, as well as a smaller build volume. I recommend getting the AI camera. It enables you to remotely watch your printer and see if everything's okay with your print. I've heard some saying that the AI LiDAR for the K1 Max seems to do nothing, therefore it may be not such a disadvantage not having it for the K1, though I will get one as soon as it's available and test it for you. I don't own a Bambu P1P for comparison, but I think the K1 doesn't have to hide from its much more expensive competitor. It still has some little issues, but the community around the K1 already started to fix them. And of course, here on 3D Printing Geek, I will show you the best ones. This is this year's last video, and I hope to see you all well and healthy next year here on 3D Printing Geek. Happy 3D printing, your 3D printing geek. Probably the chamber temperature was not high enough with a passive. Probably the chamber temperature was not high enough with a passive. As well, I think I got a frog in my throat. Oh!